I still can't really explain how it was that I came to be here. Only that I think that all of us are probably capable of committing an act completely out of character. And I know it's easy to look back on it now and say, wow, a little extreme, don't you think? Because it was.
Roger, stand by.
I was experiencing some financial, personal difficulty.
Look, you have to stop fighting this, Richard.
And I think it's true to say anyone experiencing that kind of crisis will always express it in their own individual way. And this was my way. To take everything I had, all of which suddenly seemed to be keeping me down, and to try to reinvent it into something that would get me up.
Richard. I love you.
And you know, in that moment,
Richard,
I actually thought it might work. That finally I would get my life off the ground. One way or the other. Turns out, however, that my prototype, at that time anyway, was in need of a little refinement.
Although I have decided a custodial sentence would perhaps be inappropriate in this instance, you will be required to fulfill 120 hours community service.
It's a bit run down, but no one's lived here for a while, like. What brings you here, anyway?
Take it.
And you must be Richard.
Yeah, that's right. And, you're probation.
No, Catherine's social services. They passed you on to us.
Right, okay.
Well, would you like to follow me?
Sure, yeah.
Now, we've given you Jane. She's got a strain, quite a rare strain, of motor neurone disease. So she's quite a handful, but tremendous fun.
Well, so she's in a wheelchair, then?
Oh, yes, she's in a wheelchair. And her voice has now definitely begun to deteriorate, which unfortunately does usually signal the beginning of the end. It won't be too long before she'll have to rely entirely on a speech machine. We're trying to encourage her to use it more now, but understandably she's reluctant. But it is worth remembering that mentally she's still very much all there. Or here, indeed.
Oh, sorry.
Richard, I'd like you to meet Jane. And Anne, of course.
Come on, Jane. Sorry.
Say hello, Jane.
Hi.
Hi. So you're Jane?
And you're Richard?
Yes, yes, I am.
Well, I thought it might be an idea if you'd take Jane for a short stroll, Richard. Get to know each other without us two interfering.
Absolutely.
So what do you normally do with your days then, Jane?
Stupid question.
No, I mean, you know, did you read, you know, do you watch videos, or what do you do?
I like to leave them empty.
Right, I'll take you back then, shall I?
Why did you volunteer?
I've got a lot of time.
All the volunteers I get are either desperately lonely or just sorry fuckers.
Yeah, well, much as I probably qualify as both, unfortunately, I'm not a very patient, sorry, lonely fucker. So, I'll just take you back, shall I?
I can undo it myself.
So, why don't we do this before then?
People usually feel more ridiculous walking next to me.
Yeah, why is that?
It implies friendship.
No, she really took a shine to you, Richard. That's very unusual. Might even be a first.
But Mrs. Hatchard...
Anne, please.
Anne, you know, without wanting to be in the least bit rude, I mean, I honestly don't know if... I think she, Jane, you need someone who knows what they're doing, you know, someone who's trained in it.
Nonsense, Richard. This is entirely the point of the programme. What Jane needs is to participate a bit more, do a few of the things that other people do.
Yeah, but I don't think I do the things other people do.
Richard, we can only help out 2 mornings a week. That gives Anne, well, she too needs the occasional break to get on with her life.
Yeah, but I'm sure you find somebody else, someone who's just...
Would I be right in thinking you're not here entirely of your own volition?
Tell you to run.